Good afternoon. My name is Maria Luisa Guerra. I'm Assistant Superintendent with the Edinburgh Consolidated Independent School District. Our district is located almost in the tip of Texas, right before you go into, you know, into Mexico. Our population in our city is about 56,000, and in our school district, we have about 32,000 students. We have about 176 buses that run bus routes on a daily basis. Our school district covers about 965 square miles. It is a very large school district in terms of area. We're actually the size of Rhode Island. So, we are a school district that is predominantly Hispanic, and we have a high percentage of our children. About 85% of our children come from low-income families. I was formerly high school principal, and you know, before I took this position, and when I was principal of Edinburgh High School, I actually had the opportunity to implement the Ford Pass program. This was really about 4 years ago. I attended the conference, the national conference that was held in Louisville, Kentucky, and at the time, the modules that we selected were those that we felt were appropriate in the math, science, and the social studies, and it was more of the upper class, and some of them were in the freshman classes. However, this last 2 years, especially since I have been in this position as assistant superintendent, and also, you know, realizing that college readiness is something that is so important, you know, meaning that we need to have our kids be ready for college, we started to focus more in the middle school. And so this is where the Ford Pass program now comes in. One of the things, you know, having had it at the high school, I saw that Ford Pass was a perfect program to integrate into our middle school curriculum, especially in our career and technology education classes. And it has really gone very well. As a matter of fact, this past summer, we had a very, very successful summer staff development. We had teachers from all of our five middle schools participating in the summer staff development, and were able to go back and select the modules that they were going to be implementing. And what I wanted to do really at this moment is to share with you one in particular, because this one activity that this one module that this one teacher is working with is one that will really give you an idea as to what it is that I'm talking about. We have a teacher in our district who is teaching the a business course, and it's mostly supposed to be a business course in keyboarding and helping the students to, you know, learn a little bit about the business world. Well, this one teacher selected module 7. Module 7 is the one that's titled Planning for Business and Success. And what he wanted to do was to tie this module in helping students to you know, learn a little bit more about how can they get into some kind of a business, and how will that go with the community. So what they decided to do was they decided to explore, first of all, what kind of product would they want to sell in our community, and would it sell to whom, and would they be able to produce it. And in the end, they chose that the product that they wanted to not only create but also to sell, and felt that it would sell well, would be salsa. You know, salsa is the sauce that we like to put in our tacos and I guess in a lot of other Mexican foods. But anyway, so what he did, this one teacher did, is that he engaged the students in what I think was really not only, you know, carrying out all of the activities in Module 7, but then also incorporated the math, the science, and the art. The students were incorporating the math because they really had to figure out, well, how many ingredients of each, you know, how much of each ingredient do we have to buy, and how much are we going to be planting, looking at how much dirt do we have, how much space is it going to require, how many rows, all of these kinds of things they had to calculate, so they had to use their math. Then the science came in, where they had to figure out what kind of soil do they need to prepare the soil, you know, the watering, how much watering do these plants need, and just the kinds of things that are related to science. And of course the art, they integrated that as well into this module, because at some point the group of kids needed to design the label for the product that they are actually, making. So right now, I can tell you that they've already planted all the different ingredients that it takes to make the salsa. And what they're looking at doing as a final product is, of course, having the salsa and then having the opportunity to invite the parents to come in and have a salsa taste little activity and then take orders. So this is one example where it shows that we have been able to bring the classes in the classroom alive, if you will. And not only that, but it's just the first-hand experience that the students have in seeing what it is to have a business and just the, you know, what it takes to have a good product, you know, one that is going to sell. Besides this, we have also partnered with the Texas Valley Communities Foundation. This is a foundation that they also have the goal in wanting to work with our parents and wanting to get them to be, I guess, to be well-versed in the information that parents need to have the kids be college-ready. And we have been having a lot of success with this partnership because we have been able to engage the parents in activities that have helped them to have a better understanding of what is their role as parents in helping their children to be ready for college. And I wanted to show you actually one of the posters, which was an activity that was held or that was done, you know, during this parent session. And what the parents needed to show here was, after having gone through the session that the foundation presented, they needed to show, well, what was it that you learned? What are you going to be doing differently as a parent? And this one group, which were three parents, they designed this poster to show that it was very important, first of all, that they needed to have communication between themselves, the parents, and their children. And so this is how they came up with that design here to show that was a communication. Then they also felt that it was very important to get information, you know, to learn about the different, levels, the graduation plans that we have. And by doing these two things, then you will have a college graduate. And so here in the end, it says that with the support from the parent, you will have your child receiving a diploma. So this is one example of just the kinds of things that we're able to have our parents say that they've learned as a result of participating in these activities that we have through the Texas Valley Communities Foundation. In closing, I really would just like to say that we have implemented FordPass, FordPass program in our district at the high school and now very successfully at the middle school. And it is a program that I would really say that it is a very easy to implement program because it is their modules that you integrate into the different, not only the grade levels, but the different content areas. It is very low in cost. And so really the good thing about it is that it engages the students in group activities where they have the opportunity to bring in our community members to, especially from the business community group, to come in and share with our students what it takes to be running a business. And I really just feel that it is something that is very good for all of the schools to have. And again, I do want to thank Ford for, first of all, having this program and having given me the opportunity to attend the first conference that I did about 4 years ago, because it has really made a difference in the lives of our students here in our school district in Edinburgh. Thank you.